Okay, now we want to show you how to make a screen capture on a Mac so that you can bring that screen capture into Canvas and use it in your discussions. So if you're on a Mac and I have my Canvas open over here, let's say that this image right here, let's say I want to make a screen capture of it. This just happens to be an image that is up on my screen right now. So if I want to screen capture it, what I will do is I will hold the command key down and then I will hold the shift key down, and I'm still holding both of them, and then I will add the number 4 key, and I'll click that once, and then I'll let go of all three buttons. And when I do, my cursor, as you can see over here, looks like a little target. And again, I can click and drag, and whatever is inside the box, that will be what will be screenshot. And when I let go, it puts a little file of it on my desktop somewhere, and I happen to throw it right over here on the edge. And you'll see that it says screenshot, and it gives me a .jpg because I changed my settings to make sure my Mac always gives me my file extension. I am going to close that file up there. Okay, so let's say this is the file then that I have screenshot and I want to go into Canvas. If I want to name it something specific other than screenshot, I can of course click on it and it will turn light blue, or I can click on it and click the return key. That will also turn it light blue. And then I can say, I'm just going to call it a test right now. I can name it whatever I want, keeping the file extension, of course. I'm going to click off of that. Now I want to bring it into Canvas. So what I want to do is, let me open up Canvas a little bit more so maybe it's more recognizable here. What I want to do is click on my account, my files, and you can see I have all these folders here, and I already made some folders here. I have discussion images, but if I wanted to make a folder, of course I would go over here and I would click the folder button, and I'll just make a folder to show you. I click the folder button, I would type the name in here of the folder, and then I would click the check button here. If I click the check button, then it will make a folder and put it in this list. If I click the X button, then it will delete the folder. So I'm just going to click the X button because I already have a folder made that I'm going to put my discussion images in. So I click on that folder to open it up, and then I can, and as you can see, I already have a file in here, but I can drag this guy right in here. It'll upload. Now you can see that this image is loaded to Canvas so I can use it in my discussions. So now I want to go to Dashboard so that I can go to my course and click it. I'm going to go down to Modules so I can more easily locate the discussion I want to try to attach it to. I'm going to go to the weekly discussion here. Now this weekly discussion doesn't have anything in it yet because this is week 2. You haven't seen it yet. So I'm just going to click on this. You'll notice it has no writing up here, but it does again have this familiar reply button that you are aware of. It's at the bottom of all your discussions, and that's the button you click to post your initial response. So I'm going to click the reply button, and I have this area where I can type in now. So I'm going to click in there to set my cursor in it. And if I want to add that picture in, I will go to this little button that says Embed Image, and I will click on it. And notice it gives me access to a Canvas tab, and my files are in there. And then I know the folder that I put it in, which was the Discussion Images folder, and I click on that. I find the image, selecting it. I don't have to type in anything for the alt text as a student, so don't worry about that. I'm going to update, and you see that it put the image into my discussion. My little cursor is on the end here, so I'll hit the return key so I can be underneath it, and then I can just type what I want. And type what you want in the discussion. And when you think that you're all ready, done, you can post a reply. Now, another thing that you can always do, if you see this attach button down here, the attach button will also allow you to attach a file to this versus bring it in through your discussions, right into the discussion itself. So if you want to attach an image, you can do that as well. You can click that attach button. It will allow you to browse on your computer, right? So if I click browse, I can go to some place on my computer, like maybe the desktop. I can look for, see that test file. I can go way down here and find test, and then I can say open, and the next thing I know, I have the test file attached. See, test JPEG is now attached. If I decide, oh, I don't want to attach it, I can hit the X and get it off. Now, you don't have to, of course, put it inside your discussion and attach it. You could do one or the other. And sometimes you will see this attach button, and every now and then in Canvas, it won't show up. So I wanted to make sure that you could see how to do it both inside the text area as well as an attached file. Now I will post the reply, and that means that it will push it up to Canvas for me. So I'm going to post that reply. And as you can see, there's a little test JPEG here that's attached, right? And if I click on that, it will allow me to download the file if I'm looking at it. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to say cancel. But the ones that are actually in the written area that you put in this part, they will definitely show up and be easy to see. If there's anything you don't like about your post, you can come over to this little dial over here, click on the little drop-down menu, and you can either edit it. You click the edit button and you can make changes, add to your text, take things away. Or if you click delete, it will delete the entire post. And if you're satisfied with your post, then you can leave it there. If not, you'll delete it. I'm going to delete mine because this isn't actually going to be attached to this discussion. It's just a demonstration, so I will delete it. And I am sure I want to do that, so I say okay.